Presented by Church Tech U, it's the ProPresenter show. On today's show, what's the difference between libraries, playlists, and presentations in ProPresenter 7? Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter show. This is the show where I teach all about ProPresenter. My name's Paul Allen Clifford, and before we get started, why don't you join the over 11,000 people that have already subscribed and clicked on the bell icon so that they can find out about new tutorials as I release them. So this is a question that came up in the official ProPresenter users group, and I thought, you know, I'm not sure that I've ever actually created a tutorial that specifically addresses this point. And to be quite clear, it was actually a little bit too long before I remembered a couple of these things. So I thought that we would head over to my computer and take a look at just what each of these items is. So the first of these is a library up here. I think of a library as an organizational tool, just like a filing cabinet. So for your music ministry, you might have a filing cabinet where you keep all of the paper music organized. After church, someone goes and they refile the paper music that the choir used and then get out the music for the next week. Something like that, okay? Same for if you have a worship band. You know, it might not be music with the staff and everything, but it might be lead sheets with chord symbols on it. Whatever, just to save money and not be wasteful, you might have a filing cabinet where you just keep all that stuff filed so that you can reuse it over and over again. Well, that's a library in ProPresenter. Now imagine that instead of one filing cabinet, you have a filing cabinet for every ministry. So you have one for the youth, you have one for the senior adults, you have one for liturgy, because maybe you pass out some liturgy and other is located in books, but you know, you just have another for that. Maybe your pastor has one for sermon notes, okay? Each one of those filing cabinets is a library in ProPresenter 7. So you might keep stuff that you have used in the past for a certain amount of time and reuse it from time to time. So stuff for Easter, maybe you're going to reuse in an Easter or two. Stuff for Christmas, maybe you're going to reuse in a Christmas or two. Stuff that you just use on a regular basis, maybe you're going to reuse. So that's what a library is. And those are located up here. And notice that I've got several libraries. So you can add them in any number. I would try and keep it to, you know, less than, I think about 7. It starts to get a little ungainly, but, you know, whatever works the best for you. One thing I do want to say is if I do Command F for Find here in the Mac version, I think it's Control F on Windows, I could be wrong on that, then you'll notice with the ProPresenter logo selected on the left, I can do a search for a song, in this case Amazing Grace, and notice that it searches across libraries. So it is very helpful to have the different libraries, just so that I know, okay, the version that the youth sing is probably a little bit different than the version that the senior adults sing. So I can really quickly just know, okay, this is the one I'm looking for, or this is the one I'm looking for. And if I click on it, it even gives me a preview so that I can see if it's in fact the one that I want. I can also switch to the text view to see if the text is what I want, in case it is different. So that's a helpful thing there. By the way, then I can drag and drop that into a playlist. So let's talk about what a playlist is. So if I were to select this one, notice the search window goes away when I've selected something else. It's still where I left it. It's just hiding behind the main user interface here. So this is just an order of worship. If your church has bulletins, maybe you had a list of things in the order of worship that you were going to do in order, same exact thing here. So let's say you sing Amazing Grace in 3 weeks and you sang it 2 weeks ago. You wouldn't make a new library for every week. You'd make a new library for every type of music or every type of presentation. We'll talk about that here in a second. But a playlist, that's per service or per week. You might have two services where everything's identical, but so you might use one playlist for multiple services in that case, but chances are beyond those services that are happening at the same on the same day or on the same weekend, then you're not going to reuse the playlist. Maybe you'll save it for inspiration for the future, especially for your larger attended services or events that you might want to reference in the past and in the future. Reference from the past in the future, but in general, you're just not going to reuse them. So that's what a playlist is. It's just the order of worship. Notice that they're up here in this upper left-hand corner in first library and then playlist. And you can have folders to further organize your playlist. So I have this tutorial open and portrait. That's for the portrait monitor, this guy here. So that's what this is. And when I collapse it, all those hide themselves away. So I'm good to go there. So that is the second thing, what a playlist is. Best practice that I've found is if I bring up the search thing, by the way, I can also click here to bring it up, and I find the one that I want, I can just, verify it, click and drag to wherever I want it to be in my playlist. So let's say I want it to be right here. So best practice, while it is possible to click on a library, find the thing that I want right there, drag it up and find the playlist that I want. Let's see, I think it was the Wednesday service, not that one. You see how that this is not as easy to do. So now I've found the Wednesday, and now I can drag down here and I can put it where I want it to. That's a lot harder than just using the search. So just a little thing for you to know there. Now, next, the final important piece of the puzzle, these are presentations. Now, personally, I would not have called them presentations, but I'm not the programmer. But I do think I understand the thought process behind it. So this is a presentation, Amazing Grace right here. The sermon right here, that's a presentation. A presentation is nothing more than an individual item, like an individual collection of slides, whether there's one slide or 100 slides. That collection of slides is a presentation. So let me talk to you real quick about why I think they called it that. So a presentation is... A presentation is what a collection of slides is called in another piece of software, Power something or other by Micro someone. Anyway, you know what I'm talking about. That's just a collection of slides. So more than once, probably hundreds of times, I've been at a business meeting not a church business meeting, but a business meeting, where someone will come in for their part of the presentation and they will hand me a USB drive, or I will have already gotten it, and I need to open up another instance of PowerPoint and navigate to that when it's their turn to talk, navigating away from the one that was up previously. So that is multiple presentations in PowerPoint. So think of the playlist in ProPresenter as a collection of presentations, and you don't have multiple instances of ProPresenter open, you just have a playlist that just makes it easy to go from one to the other to the other, which is another reason why ProPresenter is so great. So that's what a presentation is. It's a single collection of slides. A playlist, it's a collection of presentations for an individual event, like a worship service, like a single meeting, etc. And those are stored for the long term in libraries. And that's what the difference is between all those three in ProPresenter 7 and actually earlier. If you like this content, you'd probably like my ProPresenter 7 Quick Start course. So head on over to TDM.fyi/pro7quick. Give me your name and email address, and I'll make a login for you for free. Until next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.